In mechanics, there really are only four types of problems: momentum and the conservation of momentum, energy and the conservation of energy, dynamics, and kinematics. And in most traditional classes, these are taught in a linear fashion. One topic is taught very thoroughly. When it's complete, the next one is started. Of course, we're not going to do that because we want to be able to assimilate problems and look at the different components of it. We want to be able to recognize the momentum in a problem, recognize the different types of energy and if energy is conserved in a problem, see if there are forces and accelerations, that's dynamics, and see how position, velocity, and their rates of change affect the problem. So let's take a look at each of these in more detail. Momentum is mass times velocity. You could think of it as how hard is it to stop something that's moving. Momentum is conserved. It stays the same as long as no outside force reaches in and pushes on our system. And it can be transferred from one object to another, typically in a collision. Let's say we have two carts on a track. Cart A is moving with velocity V1, and cart B is at rest. After the collision, the two carts stick together. And move with velocity V2. But velocity V2 has to be less than velocity V1 because the mass of carts A and B together is much more than the mass of cart A by itself. You could say that cart A lost some of its momentum and gave it to cart B, and cart B gained some momentum. Or you could say the total momentum of the system is the same. At the beginning of the problem, it's all in cart A. And at the end of the problem, it's split between carts A and B. Energy is also conserved when we don't allow energy to enter or leave our system. It stays the same. It can also be transferred between two objects, like momentum. But unlike momentum, it can be transformed from one type of energy to another type. Dynamics is the study of motion using forces. When a force pushes on something, it causes acceleration. We say F equals ma, the force acting on an object is equal to the mass of that object multiplied by its acceleration. Let's take a look at this situation. We have an object, let's make it a cart, sitting on a track. It starts at rest, it's just sitting there, and we exert a force on that cart, we push on it. That's going to cause acceleration in that same direction, and the cart's going to begin to move, and it'll start to move, and then it will move faster and faster in that direction as long as we keep pushing on it. And this is true even if the cart was initially moving. If our cart was moving with velocity V1 and we pushed on it, we would get acceleration in that direction, and the cart would begin to move faster and faster and faster in that direction. This is also true if we push in the opposite direction. Let's say our cart is moving with velocity V1 to the right, and we push on it to the left. That causes acceleration to the left, which causes the cart to slow down. When the acceleration and the velocity point in the same direction, we get increasing speed. When the acceleration and the velocity point in opposite directions, we get decreasing speed. And the acceleration always points in the same direction as the net force. And kinematics uses position, velocity, and rates of change, basically math, to tell us where our objects are. Let's take a look at this example. Let's define this as being x equals 0. And our object is over here at x equals 2 meters. And it's moving. It always moves with a velocity of 3 meters per second. At this instant in time, it just happens to be at x equals 2 meters. Well, 1 second later, it's going to be here, and 2 seconds later, it's going to be here at x equals 8. And it's still going to be moving at 3 meters per second, because the distance is going to be 3 meters per second multiplied by 2 seconds, 6 meters. And it started at 2, so its final position is going to be 2 plus 6, or 8 meters. So your objective is to look at a problem through each of these lenses. Momentum. Do objects in the system have momentum? Is momentum conserved? Energy. What types of energy are there in your system? Is energy conserved? Dynamics. Are there forces and accelerations? Can we use that to figure out what's happening in the problem? Or kinematics. Do we know enough about the position, the velocity, and their rates of change to figure out what we want to in the problem?